name is Juliana Recio, and I have been working in the disability community for about 17 years. I am a person with a disability. I am a wheelchair user, and I have focused a lot of my work working with parents of kids with disabilities, and also students that are transitioning to the adult system, service system, and of course, the Latino community. It definitely has shaped my understanding of the issues that immigrants face, immigrants with disabilities face here in the United States, growing up in South America. Oftentimes we face issues of cultural barriers, language barriers, and immigration status. At the same time, oftentimes immigrants with disabilities come from developing countries and they may not have had the interventions and opportunities that we have here in the U.S. Well, access of people with disabilities after the ADA was passed has definitely increased enormously. At the same time, more opportunities, more visibility for people with disabilities. If there's anything that I believe that we still need a lot of work on is the opportunities for employment for people with disabilities. The unemployment rate is still high after 20 years of the ADA, and if you're a person of color, the unemployment rate is even higher. I think the main advice that I would give another self-advocate or a parent of an individual with a disability would be to empower ourselves through educating ourselves, training ourselves about disability rights, and at the same time that we see ourselves reflected in society and engaging in our communities. Another aspect that I think is important for people of color with disabilities is to not only see ourselves reflected in society, but also give opportunities for children and youth with disabilities for mentorship and successful individuals of color with disabilities, people from their own community. People of color with disabilities face a full range of challenges, including related to their ethnic and cultural identity, racial, and one of the things that I would like to see more is organizations implementing programs that are culturally and linguistically competent, and at the same time to make that as part of the whole makeup of the organization from top to bottom. For instance, if a Latino makes a phone call, to have somebody bilingual available to address their needs. I think that's key for access.